Okay, the question is, how do as Muslims believe that we were created from our scriptures? So in terms of Allah, we believe that Allah created God. We use the word Allah. God is, I exchange the words just because when we refer to the word Allah, Allah is the God. So we don't, I tend to use that word rather than the English word because God can be transcribed in different ways. For example, goddess, gods. But it's in terms of Allah, we believe that God created man from clay. So like a mud for mud, he fashioned a man through clay, and then he breathes his spirit into man. He breathes into man, and that's how man was created. So in terms of evolution, I'm guessing you're coming from the evolution aspect here. Is that what you're trying to say?
So, yeah.
So are you a Christian yourself?
Yeah.
So I guess the difference between is, as Muslims, we believe that evolution is, we believe in evolution, but we don't believe that humans came from apes. If that makes sense.
Yeah, okay.
So we don't necessarily deny evolution in the aspect of natural selection. So we say, for example, the Quran does not say that evolution we came from. It does not say that we came from apes. So we don't believe the fact that we came from apes. But in terms of the stage of the evolution, there's nothing that says in the Quran that goes against it.
Okay.
For example, it says in the Quran in chapter 21, verse number 30, which says, أَوَلَمْ يَرَى الَّذِينَ كَفْرُ أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ رَتْقًا فَتَفَقْنَاهُمَا وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. Which basically means that have the disbelievers not seen that the heavens and the earth were one, and then we separated them, and from every living thing we created from water.
Okay.
So if you look for when you look on different planets, well, that was the first thing to look for like aliens, etc. They look for water, don't they?
Yeah, it was. I mean, there's water on Mars.
They're looking for ice caps, but I don't think it's specifically H2O in the sense of the water that we have today. Wow. The reason they look for water on different planets is because if they find water, they're under the assumption they may be able to find life.
Yeah.
Whereas in the Quran, it actually said 1400 years ago that life came from water.
Wow.
So, and he also mentioned about the Big Bang, that everything was one and then we separated it. So the answer is that as Muslims, we don't believe that men, like human beings, came from apes, but we don't deny evolution, the process. For example,
evolution's got a big say in what's going on. I mean, animals have evolved. I don't believe we've evolved from monkeys. And obviously, you don't believe the same thing.
I can't remember.
You don't believe the same thing, do you?
I think the difference between the Bible is, I can't remember the words off the top of my head now, but the Bible is very explicit in terms of how animals were created. So I can't remember the words in the Bible now, but it's very explicit. That's why people have, for Christians, there's that sort of conflict with reason, because in the Bible it's explicitly mentioned how animals, etc., were created. But Allah in the Quran does not explicitly mention.
No, it just says that God created
them. God created man through clay. But then it said that everything was created from water. So that's the difference. Does that kind of make sense to you?
Yeah.
Are you a believing Christian yourself?
Yeah.
So do you believe that Jesus Christ was God himself?
Or God.
You believe Jesus Christ is God?
He's God.
You believe he is God?
Yes.
So what's the reason for that, if you don't mind me asking?
Because he was crucified and he was resurrected.
Okay, but even if you believe he's crucified, why does that mean he's God?
Well, he claimed to be God several times in the Bible. And he performed miracles that was a signpost which was pointing to him to say that he was God. He did claim to be God. Nobody else has ever claimed to be God.
So in terms of his claims, what was one of his claims that he was God?
It comes in all parts of scripture when he says he was God. He said, before the world was formed, I am. Which to a Jewish person, I am is claiming you're God.
So
he was claiming it was God to the Jewish authorities.
So you're referring to John 3, I believe 58, which is when they asked him, before Abraham was, I am.
Because
they were saying, how do you know when you're not even a certain age? And he said, before Abraham, I am. Well, my answer to that would be, so if there's two reasons. So firstly, if you look at the translation of the word I am in the New Testament, if you look at the Greek translation of the Old Testament, because the reason they say that when he said I am, he was referring to as God, the Christians, is because they refer to Exodus when Moses said, who are you? And he said, I am who I am. Exactly.
That's right.
But the way the Greeks have translated the Old Testament, they use the word hegoon. Hegoon is the word they use in the Old Testament.
Okay.
Whereas in the New Testament, the word when Jesus Christ said I am, they use the word hego. They use the word hego eimi. So it's not even the same word.
Right.
So if people say I any, So it's not necessarily the same word I am as in Exodus. So it's a play on translation here. And secondly, the second point, even if you translate that word as God, let's say, yeah. But before Abraham, yeah. I am. Let's say if it was God. He said, how would you know? He just basically said, before Abraham was God. He never said, before Abraham, I was God. He said, before Abraham was God. So as Muslims, we say, well, obviously God was existed before he could have told it, Jesus Christ is. Does that not make sense? Because
yeah. And then it doesn't change the way I see it.
No, absolutely.
But I appreciate. But
the reasons as Muslims, we also don't believe that Jesus Christ is God from the Bible is because there are certain verses in the Bible, for example, Matthew, Mark 13:32, when he was asked about the last hour, he goes, tell me when the last hour is, and he said, nobody knows the last hour, not the Son or the angels,
only
the Father.
Only the Father.
So don't you think that he is clearly differentiating himself here from God? Because if he was God himself, he would have known when the hour was.
Yeah, but there were certain things that he didn't know what the Father knew. The Father dwelt in him, but he didn't let him know certain things.
But why would he say that is?
I don't know. It's just one of the mysteries, I suppose.
But as Muslims, the belief that we have is that he wasn't God himself. And we don't believe in, let's say, the literal God, but let's because in the Bible, many people have been mentioned as being sons of God.
How do you explain the miracles? Bringing people back to life.
Yeah,
because I don't think your faith has done that, has it? I don't know. It's just ignorance.
No, that's a very fair question. Now, the answer is that as Muslims, we also believe in Jesus Christ.
Yes, you do.
Yeah.
Yes, I know you do.
We also believe in Moses.
I know you do.
We believe in a lot of the different prophets. And we believe that the prophets of the past also performed miracles.
Yeah.
Is that not true? Moses went to the sea and he separated the sea.
Yeah, he got authority from God to do it. And
exactly.
The disciples have got authority.
Exactly. Authority. Now, we say that Jesus Christ, when he performed these miracles, he was doing it by his Father, in this context, by God's will.
Right.
So that, for example, in the Quran, there's another miracle mentioned of Jesus Christ that's not mentioned in the Bible.
Right.
We believe as Muslims that Jesus Christ spoke as a child.
Right, okay.
So we actually believe that he spoke as an infant when he was only a couple of days old.
Right.
So as in terms of miracles we have, we do not deny that the prophet Jesus performed many miracles because he was a true prophet of God, even within ourselves. But we say the miracles were performed due to the permission of God. Same way with Islam, then the miracles are performed. We don't say Muhammad is a prophet, peace be upon him. We say he's performed these miracles through the permission of God. With Moses Christ, may he split the sea through the permission of God. So we say that these are all done by the permission of God rather than him being God himself. Because if you look at the Bible, as Muslims, we say there has never been an instance where Jesus Christ claimed to be God. What do you think of that?
I'm not convinced about what you're saying because I really truly believe that I had a Holy Spirit experience about 25 years ago when I became a Christian. I went on a Christian exploration course, Alpha. Have you heard of Alpha?
No, I haven't.
I went on an Alpha course and I was obviously searching for the truth and I got it by a massive Holy Spirit experience.
So what was the experience, if you don't mind me asking?
Well, it's quite a long, drawn-out affair, really. It was just something that happened one morning.
Okay, but my question, my sort of...
That is sort of being the anchor point. I'm going to have to get on.
No, fine, that's fine. But here is actually, if you want to ask more, but my only last point to that, the thing you said was, like, a lot of people have very personal experiences.
Yeah.
For example, as a Muslim, you might meet a Muslim and say, I had this experience, that's why I became a Muslim. Or you might meet a Buddhist who said, I experienced this, so I became a Buddhist.
Yeah.
Or a Hindu might say, I experienced this, so I became a Hindu. So all religions, can we really take personal experience as being proof of God?
Well, no, I mean, I think that was a tipping point for me to believe. But I don't often tell people about that because I don't think it's very useful saying that. Because like my son's searching for the truth.
Okay.
But he's saying, why don't I have a big experience? Now, I don't think you should have an experience to come to faith. I don't think it makes any difference whether you have an experience or not. If you come to faith, you come to faith.
By
whatever means. So I don't, you're probably one of the only people who's not a Christian I've told that to.
Thank you for sharing.
You're the only non-Christian of another faith, I've thought that too.
Yeah.
because people think you're daft. If you tell anyone,
no, we don't think you're daft.
No, I'm not saying you are, but if you say to an ordinary non-believer in the street, they think you're crackers.
We have to judge everyone in a respectful manner.
Yeah.
If you say to me you experienced this, then I'm going to say, if you experience something, then you've experienced something.
Yeah.
For example, like, I speak to many different people from different walks of life, from different backgrounds, and they're going to come with stories to me and say, this is, I've experienced this story, so that's why I follow this faith. I'm saying that story is very personal to you. I can't use your story as a personal experience to prove that God exists or doesn't exist. Like, I can't even go to a non-Muslim, an agnostic or an atheist and say, I believe in God because I had this personal experience. Because he's going to turn around and say to me, well, you can't prove your personal experience.
Well, that's what I'm saying. It's not helpful. Having an experience isn't helpful. It's helpful for the person, but not...
I've got an appointment. Have a good day.
It's good to see you.
Same to you.
Thanks for your time.
Have a good day. Oh, my ear.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.